Mike Huckabee just rescued Taylor Swift after new album gave Hillary fans nasty surprise. Katy Perry and other big celebrities gave massive support to Hillary Clinton in the 2016 presidential race. Hillary enjoyed all of the big Hollywood stars who were actively campaigning on her behalf, but Taylor Swift wasn't one of them. The 27-year-old pop star refrained from joining the Clinton campaign, and now, her new album just gave Hillary fans a nasty surprise. Luckily, after they brutally attacked her, Mike Huckabee just came to Swift's rescue. Taylor Swift is being bashed by Katy Perry and her liberal feminist cohorts who took part in the Women's March and cried like babies when Donald Trump got elected president. They became pissed off at Swift, starting back in early 2016, when she refused to jump on the Hillary bandwagon. Taylor Swift correctly recognized that she is a singer who entertains, not a political hack whose job it is to preach her brand of politics to the world. Isn't that all we ask from the Hollywood crowd? Entertain us, do your job, and leave your personal opinions on politics to yourself, just like the majority of Americans do when they go to work. So, when Swift's new song Reputation debuted from her upcoming album, once again, the holier-than-thou celebrity feminists bashed Swift. Why? Because she is refusing to mix politics with her music. The Daily Beast urged Swift to speak out in the wake of the Charlottesville, Virginia, protests which left one woman dead. Now, BuzzFeed has upped the ante against the singer in the grossest way possible, and that's not hyperbole. In the site's disgusting article titled, "Taylor Swift's Persona is Not Built for 2017, BuzzFeed claims Swift is a white supremacist, reporting, "Move over a little from there and you'll find Swift's image itself, willowy, blonde, and aggressively white. Perhaps, in an awkward corner close by, are the white supremacist fans who've claimed her as a figurehead." The article clarifies that there is nothing to their claims, saying, "There is no reason to believe she has any interest whatsoever in any of this, neo-Nazis." Yet, there is now a real smear job, started by Katy Perry, to make Swift out to be the queen of the white supremacists. All this drama just because she refuses to be political. Katy tweeted to Taylor about not supporting Hillary Clinton, finding it ironic to parade the pit women against other women argument about as one unmeasurably capitalizes on the takedown of a woman, she wrote to her nearly 73 million Twitter followers. Mike Huckabee got involved after the magazine Marie Claire joined in the brutal attack on Swift, tweeting, "We're still waiting for an explanation of Taylor Swift's decision to remain apolitical during the 2016 election. #reputation. Defending Swift, Huckabee responded, "What? At Taylor Swift 13 is too smart to alienate half her fans on either side. Her popularity grows and Oscars and NFL tank. She doesn't owe anyone her political views." Huckabee is right. When are these losers going to get over the outcome of the presidential election? Swift doesn't owe Hillary or any of these nutjobs who march around wearing vaginas on their heads anything. She is a smart businesswoman who knows that alienating half of the country is not required to be a pop star. Political commentator Bernard Goldberg points out, the BuzzFeed piece is even angry that Team Swift is suing a journalist for directly tying her to the Nazi movement. But BuzzFeed isn't alone in weaponizing the singer's skin color. Consider this think piece, "Why I'm Afraid of White Women, and Taylor Swift," referring to an actual article that appeared on the Clyde Fitch Report. Goldberg adds, "Yes, that's an actual headline for an actual story on the internet. That's where we are in race relations today. Once again, let's imagine a column with the races reversed and see where that goes." This is what it has come to in the entertainment field. Most celebrities were always liberal-leaning, but this is something different. Now, these idiots in Hollywood are demanding complete and utter loyalty to the Democratic Party, and if you stay silent, they will try to destroy you. If you come out as a conservative, your career is over, except maybe in country music, and even that's no guarantee as we see even country stars beginning to lean left. What these celebs seem to forget is that this is why Americans are boycotting the NFL and many Hollywood films. Let these losers continue to spew their hatred for half the country, which happens to be the regular middle class Americans who actually have jobs, you know, fans who actually have money to buy their tickets and merchandise. In the end, these stars might find themselves out of work for good.